Great. Okay, so let's get started. What we'll be doing today is one medical scenario. We'll try doing different situations it can be asked in the examination. How do you need to manage it? The medicine or whatever the management is there. How to demonstrate if they ask. The advantages of the medication if they ask you to. Okay. Now, all of you know, and I hope all of you have seen the introductory video of the medical emergency and how it is conducted is that there are two medical examiners. So once you go inside, they start giving you a scenario and it is verbal. Okay. So keep your ears open. It's the last exam of your ORE Part 2 examination. You're probably drained out. So keep your ears open and listen to the question because you need to pay attention to the facts they are saying and only then you will be able to diagnose it. Okay, guys, just keep giving me a thumbs up so I know that you guys are listening to me.
Yes.
Okay, great. RJ, I'll give you mic access. So. Okay, so listen to them carefully. And what you need to listen to them is you need to listen to the age of the patient. You need to listen to the medical scenarios, the medical complaints, what he's saying. If he has any medical history and all that. Okay, so that will help you give you a diagnosis. In case you do not hear, you can always ask, can you kindly repeat the question or sorry, I did not hear you. That's completely all right because sometimes you may not get it right the first time. But it just, you know, misses on your time. And you have just 8 minutes to finish your three medical scenarios. So try to be fast when you practice at home. Try to practice it in that speed. So they will tell you like there is a person and he's undergoing a crown removal. And suddenly his the crown slips from your hand and it goes into the patient's throat and the patient starts coughing and he starts placing hands aggressively on his neck. So you need to pay attention to the age, to what you are doing at that point of time, to what the patient is doing at that point of a time. And sometimes there may be a medical history. Not in this case because it's a choking case. This is not something which the patient has from before. It is an iatrogenic thing which has happened in the clinic because of you probably or because of something else. So you just need to pay attention to the age, to what you were doing at that time, what the patient was doing at that time, if that's relevant, what the symptoms is he showing, and if he has a medical history. So you pay attention to all that and these are the two different scenarios in which they can be asked. Like here it's a small child where you're doing a root canal treatment and one of the file goes missing and the patient is coughing and not able to speak. This is another patient who is 24 years old who is undergoing an onlay removal and again the onlay slips and the patient says something went down his throat but he doesn't feel anything. He feels like a little uneasy, but not any major symptoms. Okay, others all can hear me, right? Except Jasmine and RJ. Okay. So, can you tell me what the diagnosis is? This is an easy one, right? Can you tell me the diagnosis of the first case? Can you type it in your chat boxes? Because that's what we are doing. Yes, he's choking. But can you read the third question and tell me what has happened here? Is the patient choking here? No, here it has aspirated. Here it has actually gone. Yes. So this will help you. You know what happens is in the examination, your mind is running on different speeds. Okay, especially when you're giving the exam, you just listen to only removal, you just listen to slip, and you don't listen anything further, and you suddenly say choking. But that would be wrong, isn't it? Has he choked?
Is he coughing?
Is he breathing? Does he have problems in breathing? No. Okay. So in this you have to say that he is aspirating. Okay, guys? Okay. Okay, guys who can't hear or are listening to, break sounds, don't worry. It is probably the internet connection on your side. You will get a good recording because it is recording on the same link which you have. Okay? But your recording stops after 24 hours. So we will again send you a recording. We will again do a class. So don't worry, guys. We are here. We will again try and help you out as much as we can. Okay? So just don't get anxious. Okay? Now, what do you think is happening? You have to say the patient is choking, or I think the patient is choking, or the patient has aspirated. So be careful. There are two different things. Be careful to use the right one. Okay, guys? Just give me an okay and I'll go ahead. Okay. What are the clinical signs of an acute severe asthmatic attack? Now, this is something which you have to learn it by heart and you have to be quick at it. Okay? Why you have to be quick at it? Because it is something which is, it's a fact. Learn it and speak continuously in front of the examiner so that you don't lose time and you get to answer more questions. So the patient may cough and splutter. The patient may complain difficulty of breathing. His breathing may become noisy and wheezy. He may develop paradoxical chest or abdominal movements and they may become cyanosed and lose consciousness. Does everybody understand what is a paradoxical chest or abdominal movement? Okay, a paradoxical chest or abdominal movement is yes. It is an alternate movement of the chest and the abdomen, something like a seesaw. Exactly, Sabine. Okay, so when the patient is breathing heavily or is unable to breathe, his chest comes out, his abdomen goes in, his chest goes in, his abdomen goes out. Bilal, that happens because when you're not able to breathe, the body is desperately trying to make a way for breathing. And body is trying to expirate, inspirate as fast as it can. The chest is doing extra work. And that is why your body is trying to, that's an immune response. That's it. Something like how you're choking, what happens? Your chest will alternatively go inside with the abdomen, trying to gasp in as much air as much as you can so your body can survive. Okay? Yes, it uses your all accessory intercostal muscles as well. Your body is trying to save you, right? Because when you're choking, are you able to breathe? No. So to help in your breathing, the body is just trying to give you an immune response by giving you paradoxical movements and helping you to breathe. But sometimes it won't work out and you may get the patient may get cyanosed and may lose consciousness as well. So tell it in an order. Okay, don't tell the sinus and the consciousness first. Tell that in the end. Clear? How will you manage the choking patient? This is something which is always asked for every medical emergency because you as a dentist should be able to stop the condition in your clinic in case it happens. So you should always start by saying, I'll stop whatever I'm doing. I'll stop doing the crown removal or I'll stop doing the dental treatment. I will check the ABCDE and once I have diagnosed it as choking, I will do this. Now, when we talked about the patient in the scenario, was the patient conscious? Or did he fall unconscious? He was conscious, right? So your treatment plan differs. So you have to say now, because the patient is conscious, and is coughing, I will remove any visible foreign bodies from the mouth and pharynx. I will allow the patient to cough vigorously. And I will encourage him to keep coughing. Okay, that's all what you need to do in a choking conscious patient who is actively coughing. You don't have to do anything else. It's a very simple medical emergency. After that, the examiner will give you any one of the four different scenarios. Okay. Now, guys, we talked about an aspiration also. I will come to that. Right now, we are talking about choking. Okay. So, all of you in track with me? Okay. So, the first scenario the patient, the examiner may say is the patient is conscious but not coughing, can't speak, can't breathe. Okay. Now the patient is conscious, but he is not able to cough. He is not able to remove that choked particle. What will you do? Now you have to go to the second stage, that is giving five slaps on the back and giving five abdominal thrusts. That is also known as the Helmut's manoeuvre. And you will keep doing this repeatedly, alternatively. Guys, I'll just stop the mic access because there's a lot of background noise. Okay, so look if the object is dislodged and keep performing it and repeat this till either the object gets dislodged or the patient becomes unconscious. Obviously, right? If the object gets dislodged, you're not going to continue it. And if the patient becomes unconscious, you have to go to something else. So you have to tell this in a good way. You have to say, okay, now the patient is not coughing, not breathing, but is conscious. So I will give him five slaps with the palm of my hand between the shoulder blades. I will keep looking if the object gets dislodged. If not, I will perform five abdominal thrusts. I will keep looking if the object is dislodged. I will keep continuing to do this until the patient becomes unconscious or the material gets dislodged. Clear, guys? Easy one. Now, if the choked material comes out, what will you do? You will calm the patient. You will check the dislodged material. Has the entire crown come out? Has the entire onlay come out? Has the entire file come out? Sometimes the patient may still feel uneasy because of the choking. So you can give him a salbutamol inhaler. Okay. And you then have to refer the patient for an X-ray. Why do you have to do that? The material is out. Still, why do you have to refer him for an X-ray? Yes, because of your back slaps and your abdominal thrust, there is an extreme chance that the patient may have had an internal injury. And to check that, you have to send him for an X-ray. Okay, is it clear? Now, this is something which is rarely asked. It may or may not be asked, but it is an unseen question. Better to do it. Now, if the patient falls unconscious, what will you do? Obviously, you will start your CPR. So you will tell him that I will start CPR because the chest compressions will not only help in dislodging the choked particle, it will also help in providing circulatory support to the patient. That is your third scenario. Now, you remember one of our scenarios was aspiration. He had aspirated the material, but there was no choking, right? If that is the scenario, then you will directly do nothing. You just have to calm the patient.